Welcome back to part two of my Famicom slash NES collection. Start here with Kage, which is known in these parts as Shadow of the Ninja. Some people like it more than others. I actually think it's one of the best action games on the system, so I definitely recommend it. I mean, come on, ninjas, you can't go wrong. We know that. It's definitely fairly unforgiving and can be annoying with its power down of your weapons when you get hit, but if you can overcome that, it's actually a very solid game. Next up, Double Dragon 2, The Revenge. It's far better than the original Double Dragon on NES, and if you don't think so, you're an idiot. That's how it is. This one has the co-op that the other one did not have, and it's just plain awesome. Plus, this particular version, the Famicom version, is actually can be made easier, and you can still finish the game, unlike in the North American version, where if you set it on easier difficulty, you are not allowed to complete the whole game. So this one has all difficulties you can complete the game with, so makes it easier to learn it and then go back and, you know, beat it on harder difficulties, which I've done on one life because I'm just that good. What can I say? Next one is the one everyone should be also familiar with, if you're familiar with the system. It's Batman. The Sunsoft Batman, which is awesome, and everyone knows it. So this is no different than the North American version, and it's pretty sweet. This here, if you guessed it's a Kirby game, you are right. Better known as Kirby's Adventure. This title here is Hoshino Kirby. Really, really, really good game. Follow-up to the Game Boy original. It's got pretty damn good graphics for the system, and they up the gameplay to take powers from the enemies, and it's definitely a lot better because of it. Next up, this is one that didn't come here. It's Exerion, or however you say that. The single screen Galaga type clone that Jalica made. I actually think it's pretty good. I like it a lot. It has a single shot and a double shot you can do with A and B buttons separately, and you only have a limited amount of shot with the single shot because it's rapid, whereas the other one is not. It's a lot slower. It's actually a pretty solid game. I like it quite a bit, even though the title screen music is pretty annoying because there's no music in the rest of the game as far as I know. This next one is Twin B. See, there's no title on that, so there's your title. First Twin B game ported to Famicom. It's a pretty awesome game. It's the cute 'em up, as it is known as, by Konami with the bell power-ups. It's pretty good. We have one of the sequels from the same system that didn't come here either, known as Twin B 3. The subtitle is Poco Poco Daimyo, I believe, something like that. Yeah, this one's not so good. It's pretty, mainly because it's so easy that, like, the first or second time I played this game, I was like, hey, I can beat it on one credit. Wow. You know? And I could even go through. Actually, I had one life to the first loop, and then I one credited the second loop, and it's just like, I'm bored, I want to do a third loop. Yeah, it's a little too easy, but it's still okay, as long as you don't mind that it's way too easy, I guess. This next one here is a very well-known game. It's Contra. Yes, this is much better than the NES version, as you may have heard. So, yeah. Pretty sweet. We all know about that. It has pulsating backgrounds like the stage 8, and it's just amazing. So my battery's running out. I guess I'll have to have a part 3 forcefully. Damn you, batteries. Catch you then.